Okay, in the last video, we looked at adding the BGE embeddings to our retrieval, QA, the RAG model that we've been working with. Now, up until now, we've been looking at using the Llama 2 70 billion model here. And you can see that adding the BGE embeddings still meant we got good quality output, but we're definitely getting some artifacts on some of these things where we're getting the right answer, but then we're also getting incorrect answers after this. And so in this video, I want to do two things. I want to look at, one, can we go for a smaller model? And then after that, can we actually, you know, improve this so that we don't get things like this? So here we can see that we've got the context window for Llama 2 has been expanded, and this is the correct answer, but then we've got all this weird stuff after it. So it's giving us the correct answer and then going on with this. So first off, let's see, okay, how well does this sort of notebook work if we just change the model to, say, the 13 billion? All right, so here's the Llama 2 13 billion model. And you can see that all that I'm still using Together API for now, just because it's nice and quick for us to test. I'm still using the same class for instantiating the model. And you'll see this is set to the 70 billion if we had it by default, but we're going to instantiate it with the 13 billion in here. So everything is the same in here. We've got the BGE embeddings going on. We're bringing in, you know, the different stuff. We're making our chain. And we're getting out pretty decent answers with the 13 billion. We can see that not all of them are totally correct, though. So the context window for Llama 2, it's just saying that it's 40% larger than the pre-training corpus. So it's missed out on getting that one right. We can see that it gets that it was trained on 2 trillion tokens. We can see it gives us a nice answer for, you know, Llama 3 is not out, although it says it's not coming, which is funny. And then some of the other ones, it's doing pretty good job. And actually, it, you know, doesn't have as bad sort of add-on outputs to this. There are some of them there when you play with this going through it. What about if we try with the 7 billion model? Okay, so this is now using the 7 billion model. And you'll see that, you know, again, everything exactly the same. The only thing we've changed in here is that we're moving to the Llama 2 7B chat in here. And we can see that, okay, here we're back to getting like the correct answer, but then we've got like unhelpful answer and some other stuff in there. I'm not sure why it wants to continually give us a lot of unhelpful answer things in there. And then we can see that, okay, this answer is clearly wrong. What is the context window for Llama 2? And it basically says it's 50% of the safety data used. So at this stage, we know that the context that it's getting back from the BGE embeddings are the same as what we were getting for the 70 billion, for the 30 billion in here. So the problem is probably not in the context that we're getting back. It's probably going to be in the language model taking and using those here. Now we can see it still gets a lot of the answers right. Although we do have a lot of this note, this answer is based on information. We've got lots of extra stuff in there that we probably don't want in there. So the next way to fix this is to look at our QA chain and work on the prompt in there. So in the next part, we're going to stick to the 7 billion parameter Llama 2 model, but we're going to play with the prompt and change the prompt. So let's jump into that. Okay, so here we are. Again, we've got everything just set to the Llama 2 7 billion chat model in there. We've got our BGE embeddings in there like before. We're setting up the Chroma DB like before. We're making our retriever return 5 contexts back. And this is where we start to change it. So here is the example of the default Llama 2 prompt style. Remember, if you go back to some of the videos where I talked a lot about Llama 2, we have both a system prompt and an instruct prompt in here. So this is their default system prompt. You are a helpful, respectful, and honest assistant. Always answer as helpfully as possible while being safe. Your answers should not include any harmful, unethical, racist, sexist, toxic, dangerous, or illegal content. Please ensure that your answers are socially unbiased and positive in nature. So this is heavily slanting it. You can see even here, and then we've got some nice stuff about if a question does not make sense or is not factually coherent, explain why instead of answering something not correct. If you don't know the answer, please don't share false information. So I like the last part of this, but we don't want it to be perhaps as politically correct or in a way getting confused by trying to remove all the toxic and dangerous stuff. For some things, you're going to want some of these things in here. So I'm not saying that you should always take them out, but they themselves are going to have an impact on the answers that you get back. So you really want to craft this system prompt. So the one that I've gone for, and this is just after playing with it a few times of trying out different things, seeing what worked. The one that I've gone for here is something that I'm trying to stick as close to the default as possible, but I want it to use only information from our context, and I want it to basically stick to that context and not give us any of the extra stuff out that we were getting a lot with the 7B model and the 70B model and a little bit with the 13 billion model as well. So the prompt I'm going for, the system prompt, is you are a helpful, respectful, and honest assistant. Always answer as helpfully as possible using the context text provided, right? We're gonna flag the context text that we put in there. Your answers should only answer the question once, so don't answer it twice, right? And not have any text after the answer is done. So that's the key, you know, this is my way of trying to stop it from just going on with things later on. If a question does not make any sense or is not factually coherent, explain why instead of answering something not correct. If you don't know the answer to the question, please don't share false information. So that one I've kept exactly the same as what Meta had. Now, in the instruction, I'm going to pass in context, two new lines, and then pass in the context in there. And then I'm going to have question and then the question. So you can see that our final prompt comes out something like this, where it's formatted for the instruction prompt with the system prompt in there. We've got our context in there. We've got our question in there. All right, I just instantiate the Llama 2 model just like we did before. In this case, I'm not trying to change temperature. I'm not trying to do anything else fancy. At first, we're just trying to get this prompt to be pretty solid. And now I basically need to instantiate, you know, the prompt template. So this is our prompt template that we've had up there. It's just regenerating it, passing it into the prompt template here. The two things that we're going to swap out as input variables will be context and question. Now, for generating the actual prompt template, I'm going to basically use our function getPrompt to pass in our instruction template, our system template in there. And then from these, we're going to pass in two input variables to these. So this is going to be the context and it's going to be the question. We're then going to basically, so I'm calling this the Llama prompt, right? I could call it the Llama rag prompt or something in here. And then I'm going to basically say chain type, and because this is just going to be extra arguments that get passed into our chain. And in this case, we're going to pass in the prompt in here. So you can see here now when we generate our chain, we're passing in our LLM, which we know is going to be the Llama 2 model. So it's our together LLM in there. We've got our retriever, which is going to pass back 5, you know, examples each time. Let's just, you know, go over that. And then we're passing in these other arguments in here, which is really where we're passing in our prompt in there. I'm still going to do the return source documents equals true so that we can cite our sources for this. And then the rest is basically the same, right? So I've just got, you know, the things for helping cite the sources. And then now when I run it, you can see now, okay, what is flash attention? So it gives us the answer for flash attention. We can see that we're getting, all this is, you know, going to be the same because we're still using the same BGE embeddings, etc. But you'll notice now we're not getting anything extra coming out of this. So we don't have answers after this. Now remember, the context window is one of the ones that it kept getting wrong before. Even though we were confident that the answer was in the context that we were passing in, because we know it worked for the 70 billion, but it didn't work for the 13, it didn't work for the 7 billion. But here we can see it's working. The context window for Llama 2 is 4096. Now it's interesting that it's not giving us any of the other junk after it, because our prompt is saying, only give us one answer. Once you're finished with the answer, you know, basically don't say anything else, right? How many tokens was Llama 2 trained on? 2 trillion tokens. Again, we don't have any of the unhelpful answer or any of the other junk that we had coming out after this. Okay, sorry, when is Llama 3 coming out? The answer to your question is not available, as the text you provided does, and see, when it says this, it shows us that it's using those contexts. Does not mention any information about the release date of Llama 3. The text only provides information about the current version of Llama, which is Llama 2, and its performance on various benchmarks. This is definitely a much more sort of succinct, truthful answer, rather than trying to make up something. When we try to confuse it about, okay, what is the new model from Meta called? In this case, it's pulled all Llama 2 stuff, so we would expect it to say Llama 2, which is what it does. It is interesting that it's, I need to probably check the paper again, it's not doing the two capital L's and the capital MA here. So I'm not sure in the paper, do they actually just go default back to referring to it like this, possibly. All right, then again, Toolformer, we've got a good answer. Again, nothing else coming out in here. And then the interesting thing that I think that this prompt helps it do too is that if it wants to pull sort of parts of the answer from multiple contexts, it can do that as well. So you can see here how many examples do we need to provide for each tool. So it starts off, the number of examples required for each tool depends on various factors, including complexity of the tool. So this is a good answer. And then we're sort of getting, you know, because we got some interesting stuff back from Toolformer, from Llama 2, from augmenting LLMs, it's incorporating all of this into, you know, this answer in here. Now, that's, you know, maybe it's not the perfect answer, and maybe the 70 billion would do certainly a lot better. So, you know, you could go back and try the 70 billion with this new prompt and see how it does as well. I do think that with this answer, we've definitely gone to a better quality answer with the retrieval augmentation for LLMs. Here we're getting, you know, much more stuff that the augmenting LLMs is a survey paper, meaning that it covers lots of different types of things. It's pulled back a few different types in here, and we're seeing that we're getting that sort of covered. We've got the dense and sparse retrievers, we've got external knowledge sources. There's a bunch of different things in here which are kind of useful for this. Finally, our what is React thing. Again, just notice that we don't have any of the, you know, an unhelpful answer, any of that stuff out. So just by, you know, by playing around and fine-tuning this prompt or tuning this prompt, and when I say tuning here, I'm not talking about doing anything with code. I'm just literally talking about sitting there and playing with it until you get a prompt that works nicely. We're able to improve the result of the overall thing in a big way. So if you're building, you know, so you should definitely customize your prompts. The big thing I wanted to sort of say here, and this is something often I will show you some new skill or something, and I will use the default prompts. But if I was going to build something for production, I will go through and spend quite a bit of time playing with the prompt, getting the prompt, working on all the things related to that prompt. Anyway, I will give you these notebooks. You can have a play with yourself. Don't forget the notebooks. I always put the notebooks in the description so that you can actually load up the notebook. I know some of you asked me in the questions, hey, can you try out this prompt on it or something? You know, you can do that, right? Just open it up, do it, especially these ones I've been doing recently. You can just go and get your free API key from Together. You can use the, I'm using the T4, which is the free GPU that you can use on Colab here. So all of these things you can play around with yourself. Anyway, as always, if you've got any questions or comments, please put them in the comments below. If you found this useful, please, you know, click like, subscribe, share the videos on social media, etc., to help other people. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.